Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Let us see the project title.
The title of the project is Multi-Party Access Control for Online Social Networks, Model and Mechanisms. Let us see the abstract of the project. The most of the model people are more interested in the online social networks. The online social networks makes the people always connected together.
The online social networks such as Facebook, Google Plus and Twitter are inherently designed to enable people to share personal and public information and make social connections with friends. We have seen unprecedented growth in the application of OSNs. For example, Facebook, one of the representative social network sites, claims that it has more than 800 million active users and 30 billion pieces of content shared each month. To protect the data, access control has become the feature of OSN. The typical online social network provides each user with a virtual space containing profile information, a list of users, friends and web pages such as Wall in Facebook, where users' friends can post content and leave messages. A user profile usually includes information with respect to the user's birthday, gender, interest, education and work history. In addition, users cannot only upload a content to their own sites or other spaces but also tag other users who appear in the content. Each tag is an explicit reference to that links to user space. For the protection of user data, current OSN indirectly require users to be system and the policy administrators for regulating their data, where users can restrict data sharing to specific set of trusted users. The online social network often use user relationship and group membership to distinguish between the trusted and untrusted users. For example, in Facebook, user can allow friends, friends of friends, groups or public access to their data. Even the online social networks currently provide simple access control mechanisms, allowing users to grow and access to information contained in their own spaces. Users unfortunately have no control over the data residing outside their spaces. For instance, if a user posts a comment in a friend's space, he cannot specify the users can view the comment. In other case, when a user uploads a photo and tags friends who appear in the photo, the tagged friends cannot restrict who can see this photo. Even though the tagged friends may have different privacy concerns about the photo, to address such critical issue, the proposed system is introduced. To overcome these problems, the system proposed a policy specification to protect the user privacy. The system proposed access control model fits well for the multi-party user environments. Let us see the block diagram of the project. Here, in the social network, we should create a user. The user information should be connected by the site. Here, the username should be a unique one. The user's full name can be anything. That is, many users can contain the same name, but the username should be a unique one. So, we can use the user ID as email of the user. Here, at first, the profile of the user is created. Then, the user can be give friend request to another friends. If a friend is accepted his request, then both the users becomes the friends. So in the friend list, it will display the friends names in the each other's wall. So here we can specify the privacy policy of our friend list and the post which we are going to post. Here the user panel has a privacy restriction as private and public. If a user set his privacy in public, the user's username can be displayed in all the friends friend list, so any user can know his name can be displayed his friend list. So to avoid this privacy missing, the proposed system introduces the privacy missing elimination system. So here when the user put his privacy into private, the user cannot be displayed in any of his friends list. No user can know that the current user is friend with which user. And the next process is the policy specification. When a user uploads a photo, he can specify who can view this post in his friend circle. To provide the restriction, the proposed system provides the user, friends, groups and relationship. So we can restrict the persons who are in the groups and the relationship. We can give the restriction of a post according to these types. So we can remove the post by setting the privacy in public or private. If a group is set to public, that group member cannot view the post. So when a user restriction is when the post setting is in the public, then only the user can see his post. Let us see the demo of the project. Here the username password field is given for the login purpose. Then next, for the sign up purpose, that is new user account creation, we must fill these details provided here and then we can upload the profile picture. When we click the sign up, we can get a success message, that is the user account is successfully created. Here the username should be a unique one. If we type the username which is already taken, it will show the error message. Let us fill all the details. Here all the details has been filled up, then we should click the sign up, we can get the success message, then we should log in. So here we should type the username and the password. When the username and password is correct, we can get the success message and it will redirect to the next page, that is home page. Otherwise it will just show the error message. So here the username and his mail ID and the code is represented here. At first we should give the friend request to the friends. To do that, we should first click the find friends. Here we should type the friend's name. If the friend name is available, it will show the result. So we can give the request, so we can get the success message. So we should log out, then log in the S2. So here when we click the friend request, we can see the S1 is given a friend request. So we can accept or deny the request. So we first accept the request. So now both the users are friends, that is S1 and S2 are friends. Here we should set the relationship for the S1. When we click update, it has been updated. Next, we should choose any one group for this user. When we click the update, we can get the success message. When we click the home button, we can see the friend name is in the friend list. So now S1 is a friend with S2. Then we should find another friend, S3, and we should give the request to S3. Then log out. We must log in as the S1. Here we can see the S2 is a friend for S1. So the name is displayed in the friend list of S1. Then we must set the relationship setting for the user S2. Here we should click the friend name, click the set relationship. Here the relationship can be set and the group also can be set. Here the user can be set his privacy policy, whether public or private. Normally first we should set as public. When we click update, the username has been updated. When we click home, it can be go to home. We just log out, then log in as S3. When we click the relationship setting, we should click the friend request. It will show the friend request of S2. Click accept and set the relationship. We should set the relationship, that is privacy setting. Here we should set privacy setting as public. We can see the S2 name in the friend list. We must log out and log in as S2. Here we can see that S1 and S2 both are friends with S2. So we should set the relationship. Here the relationship can be set as public. Then for relationship setting is S3 is set. We should click relationship and then click the groups. So we should go to S3 login. Here when we click the S2, it will redirect to the S2's wall. So here S1 and S3 are friends for S2. Here we have set the privacy setting as public for both the users. When we change the privacy setting, the reflection can be shown here. We must log out, then log in as the S1. When we click the relationship setting, we have to click private. So when we click the update, the privacy setting can be updated, so the corresponding message can be shown here. When we click the logout, then we should log in as S3. So when we click the S2, the S1 is hidden from here, so the privacy setting is achieved likewise this. So when we click home, we can now post some photo. Here we must choose a photo, then we should set the relationship and the group. So this post is set as public, so anybody can see this post. So when I click the my post, we can see the post and we should log out and we should click the S2 as login. So we should click the other post, we can see the post posted by S3. So we should again log out and then log in as S3. And again we should choose a photo, so we set the privacy setting as private for both. When we click update, it has been updated. When we click the my post, the post posted by current user is shown here. then we should log out, then log in as S2. When we click the login, it should log in. Then when we click the other post, we can see only one post is shown here, but the user has been posted two posts. So here the privacy setting is in private for the second post, so only the user cannot be able to see the post. Thank you.